Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Dondre and Nicole, and you're checking out Madtalkin.
I like the way you look. You're killing it.
Oh, thanks. You're killing it, too.
You know.
Hey.
Oh, look at your ponytail.
Hey.
You're killing it.
Minimum right now, I think I pulled a ligament. Fashion killer, a liar assassin. Vet mom villain, Balenciaga. Got that melanin magic. Brown skin popping, always.
The Atlanta native Anthony Hamilton, how are you?
I'm great.
Yes.
Charlotte, North Carolina. Everybody thinks I'm from Atlanta because
right. Why is that?
Because I was signed to So Def forever.
But got it.
North Carolina.
Everybody was signed.
Beautiful, too. I could be from here.
Right. All right.
So, citizenship.
Right. So tell me, you know, with neo soul, you know, R&B, you know, it seems like it's fading. How do you plan on making it relevant? I mean, more mainstream.
You just keep singing. Keep singing loud and keep putting out great music and great quality music, and the people are going to still believe in it. Yeah.
Right. We're still here. So I know that that you went through a divorce sometime, and you know, you were married for so long. You sung so much love songs to us, you know. So I felt connected. So how did you overcome that marriage?
Well, we're still close. We're still co-parent, three amazing kids, and I support her. She's out in California right now, working on her career.
Right.
And just the love that we had, it doesn't die.
Right. Doesn't,
you know,
die.
Just like things,
that.
Yeah.
I love that.
So.
All right. And tell me, for the last question of the evening, you know, black excellence. You know, this is what tonight's all about. It's about black excellence. So tell me, what does black excellence mean to you?
Black excellence means power.
Wow. That's it.
A lot of power. Mm-hmm. Perseverance. And just us as people, we've overcome so much.
Yes.
I think we're triumphant.
Triumphant. Well, you represent all of that. I want to thank you so much. What's up, everybody? We are here with the actor, the writer, the comedian, Rodney Perry.
Yo, what's
yo,
up?
Yo, you turn up.
You got to turn up, man. I'm on with you.
That's what we do.
You done took it to another level. You got lights on your little red carpet area. You took it to another level. I like that. Yeah.
All right. So now with you just being, you know, such a prominent figure in the African-American community, so
I am
long
that.
And a role model, how important is tonight for you?
Oh, tonight is more important than any other award show for us.
Right.
You know, I was saying to one of the other interviewers that there won't be no boycotts tonight. Mm-hmm. There won't be no people taking knees because this is us celebrating us. And this is so important when you stop and say to somebody that look like you, you killed that. That's a good deal. And so I'm excited about it for that. And I've had a chance to be a part of the ceremony before. And it's just dope, man. You know, it's dope. You dope.
Look at your ponytail.
Hey.
You're killing it.
Thank you.
And all these beautiful black folks, man, doing it. It's amazing.
We are here with the singer, Dondria. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. I feel like it's been a while. So speed us up.
Okay, well, listen. So I just dropped an EP called The Day of the Dawn, and it's been 7 years since my last project with JD. So this is like, oh, my God, she is back. Okay?
Right.
Make sure y'all get it. It's on iTunes and everywhere else.
Right. We will. Now, tell us, you know, what are the hardships of artists, you know, when they take those big breaks? How hard is it to come back hard to make sure that everyone receives your music well?
Well, I think for me, the thing has been, you know, music kind of shifted. When I first came in, I was like on the tail end of what I like to call authentic R&B, and it just switched on me. So, you know, it's important to, well, it was important for me to find where I fit in without doing stuff that's not true to who I am. So, I did that. We back now.
We back now. And just tell me, you were talking about the shifting of music, you know, and how it sounds so much different to the authenticity of R&B. So now that it has changed, are we going to be hearing a little bit more of them or the R&B Dondria?
We're going to always hear the R&B Dondria. I have to, that's what I'm here for, to give you that. So now if I don't put a little twist on it, you know, gotta keep up, but I'm always gonna give you like that essence. Yeah.
What's up, everybody? We are here with Ashley Love Mills from Tyler Perry's Too Close to Home. How
yes,
are you?
Yes, I'm great. How are you?
I'm doing great. Now, listen, you know, today, you know, we're gonna go ahead and honor the unsung heroes. And with you being a model, I'm pretty sure you experienced many challenges.
Yes.
So tell me, what are some of the challenges that you have overcome?
Oh my goodness. One, for example, I competed for Miss North Carolina 4 times before I won. And competing in a red state is kind of a challenge. I had a lot of people that told me that I could never win, especially being an African-American young woman. And I did win on my fourth try, and I became the fifth African-American woman to win in the state of North Carolina.
So when you had that first loss, were those words going through your mind like they said I couldn't win?
Yeah, a little bit. A little bit, yeah.
So what was it that pushed you to do it again?
You know what? I am a person, like, if you tell me I can't do something, then I'm going to find a way to do it anyway.
T.C. Carson, Mr. Kyle Barker, looking smooth once again.
How you doing, dog?
Good. How are you?
I'm well. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, we already know, you know, you're a prominent figure when it comes to Black excellence. Just playing such a pivotal role with the 90s hit show, Living Single, which is now on Hulu. Congratulations on that. Dab, dab right there. So tell me, what is it about this generation that you think is so unique and how you're going to add to our future?
Wow, that's a good question. I think it is the digital connectivity that this generation has. I think that's very unique to who they are right now and the way they're using those platforms. And so in order to be current, you have to know how to use those platforms.
Correct. Yeah. And now with you, what you got going on? You always got something up your sleeve that you just don't quite say. So discreet with it.
A lot of music going on. If you go to my Facebook page, we just did a live recording, and there's some video footage from that. So we're going to drop this album probably in the next couple of months. Thank you.
Keep the hope alive and stay working. Thank you. With Serta Baptist, how you doing?
I'm good. How you?
I'm doing good as well. Now listen, a little bird told me that you date Brandy. Is that true?
Have I dated Brandy?
Don't be denying your girls on the camera.
No way. We're good friends.
Good friends. That's what's up. So what do you think about love and relationships, though? How important is it in our society today?
You know, it's very important. But, you know, what we have to do is find a balance between expectations, you know what I mean? It helps us to where no one walks away brokenhearted, you know what I mean? And that's the most important thing, because you don't get in a relationship to hurt anyone. So I think relationships, we have to understand it a different way. And then we have to approach it differently, you know? It's time out for throwing shade, being petty. Like, if you want a person in your life, you have to make sure that you show them love and kindness. You never know how long you got somebody, you know what I mean?
So especially coming from a man.
Well, you know, listen, there's some good guys out here. We just all get beat up in a way that's unfair. But you know what? It's a part of character. Yes. And those who stand up against that and have strong character, that's a real man. Not your muscles. You have men and then you have champions.
You better preach. That's right, you guys. Serta Baptist, we're going to be looking out for you. You sounded like
girl.
The president.
You sound good, guys. Ah.
And I wish. Signor. I love that song. I love that song. It's such a legacy.
Everybody has a song in their heart.
Right. Yeah. Well, tell me, was that story true about you? Did you write that about yourself?
It was... The story is definitely autobiographical. The song proves that God himself has a sense of humor. So,
right.
You know.
Definitely related to home.
Yeah. And I was really surprised to see so many other people could relate to the story.
Right. Can we hear some new music from you coming soon?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Absolutely have a new project. That's an EP that should be coming out, which is actually my first self-titled project.
Right.
So I'm really excited about the range and freedom of that project.
Correct.
So. It's going to be a whole lot of fun.
Well, we're going to be looking for it. Thank you so much for keeping R&B alive.
Take it.
Judge Maybelline. Now, look, I'm going through a divorce.
Oh, you better know what you're doing. Okay, make sure you have all of your information before you go to court. Make sure you've done your homework. Make sure you know all the assets, all the debts, all the liabilities. Make sure you got it together, okay?
Okay.
All right.
No, but on a serious note, how prevalent do you think marriage is in today's society?
How prevalent?
Yeah. Do you think, like,
the rates are down. America is no longer believing in traditional marriages.
Right.
Most of us are shacking up, is what I call it, from my generation. You all calling it having a mate and living together and testing the waters or whatever. I call it shacking up. So most of the, you know, there's a new attitude about marriage. There's a new attitude about families. There are new attitudes about having babies and when you have them, when you don't have them, how you raise them, how you don't raise them. So, you know, America's changing. But I still believe in the concept of marriage.
Amen. The woman of the hour, how are you?
I'm wonderful.
You look so beautiful.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you.
Now, you seeing this legacy unfold before you that, you know, you were a part of, how does this make you feel?
Well, I feel good because it tells me that the work continues.
Correct.
The message continues. We've got to continue to educate our young people
as
to the contributions we've been making all along and continue to make. So whatever method we have, whatever opportunity we have to do that, I'm proud to be a part of it.
Well, thank you. We are so proud of you. I'm proud to be a part here just standing before you. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, you guys look wonderful. So, you know, this is a night, you know, to contribute to the African-American community and celebrate and honor, you know, the great things that we have done. So why was it important for you to come out tonight?
Well, not to sound selfish, but my father passed just this last year, and they're honoring him tonight. Thank you so much. So it's an honor. It's a pleasure. We definitely wanted to stand up, show a united front. We're here. We're happy. We're grinning. He's with God. It's a homecoming. It's a homegoing, so we're excited. And my mother came out here too. Help just show how black don't crack.
Yes.
And God is good. God is very good.
All the time. And, you know, they say this term unsung heroes all the time, you know.
Right.
I don't really believe in that term, for instance, because I feel like we're always singing. We're always doing something, whether we're getting glory or not.
Right.
So tell me, just, you know, what you said, your father passing, how did you cope with that? How did you overcome to stay in the game?
God, I mean, you know, for one, there was no unresolved issues with me and my father because we had a good line of communication, so nothing was left unsaid, you know. He was a traveling man, but he always he showed how much he loved his family every time we saw him. He wasn't a quiet man. He didn't keep things to himself. He wasn't closed in. He was very boisterous. He filled up a room. So it was joyous. It was sad. But at the same time, again, it was a party.
Right.
You know what I mean? He did get saved.
Right.
Okay, so we know where he's at.
Right.
And we have a peace. And this woman right here is so strong. She held us together. You know what I mean? When we wanted to crumble. So, you know, we just had to show everyone that God is good. He lives through us. He lives on. And we're very excited to be here.
Look, he praises you so much. You raised a good son.
Well, I'd love to take the credit, but it was our Lord Jesus that kept us through it. But I have to mention Cuba Gooding, senior of the Main Ingredient, has blessed this city, and he was always out here fighting for the common man and his people. So we want to thank the Trumpet Awards and the Bounce Net for this incredible honor, and it's just amazing just to be here on this in this evening.
Thank you guys so much.
Hey, what's happening? This is Carl Thomas, and you're watching Madtalkin. Keep it locked.
Hey, what's up? This is Anthony Hamilton, and you're checking me out on Madtalkin.